Hello there guys and welcome back to the channel. So I recently got lucky enough to dupe 6-star Cal Obsidian. He's still at rank 1 and in today's video we're gonna be doing a full run through Realm of Legends, and then at end of it gonna take a look at some stats, some numbers, hit counts, kill times and so on. I have sped up all the footage in this video times 1.5 speed just so this wouldn't end up being a 20 minute video, but that is about how long it is gonna take us to clear entire Realm of Legends, because I edited out all the loading screens for most part and like me crossing the path, so I left in pretty much only the fights, and all that added up to about 18-19 minutes, which isn't bad at all considering there are 11 opponents in Realm of Legends. But yeah, so let's get to the fight. Basic idea here is obviously going to be we're going to try to hit exactly 3 heavy attacks at beginning of every fight, activate route and do a massive burst damage. For most part I found that to be kind of like the most effective way to do a huge chunk of damage at beginning of the fight, to try and combine that route buff together with all your Thanos' blessings. And I definitely have to say that that Ebony Maw synergy with increased crit at the beginning of the fight, plus the fact that my Cal Obsidian now is awakened, has definitely drastically increased his damage output, especially for the fights where he doesn't have like max Thanos' blessings. Because I did pretty much the same fight with a similar team, Cal Obsidian unduped, and I believe it was about 200 hits to take down Winter Soldier with suicides. But yeah. So right here we're 90 hits in and he's already in assassin's range. As you can see, it's not gonna last much longer than this. We reactivated our route, so we're basically going for our last final burst amount of damage. 2 hits in, 110 hits if we include the last few, and Winter Soldier goes down. So first fight, 110 hits for 6-star rank 1, not bad at all. Now, because we had Ebony Maw synergy and we did finish the fight while route buff was active, we are on 4 missions already, because we knocked down an opponent, we didn't lose our combo and we had a route active. So here we landed 3 heavy attacks and let's just see how much damage we can deal here. First 15 hits, already 15% of the damage, but that's not it, because now our armor breaks are more potent and will last longer, so it means we can stack up more of them. And so basically at this point I just want to get to my level 3. And before doing so, just kind of make sure Captain Marvel has as many armor breaks on as I can possibly stack with her, within reason. And yeah, so here, 34 hits in, we're launching our special 3, while just like freshly activating a route. I did find that to be kind of like the best damage source. That route buff with special 3 combined does insane amounts of damage. But yeah, so we reactivated our Thanos' blessings, we had route active before. 51 hits in and Captain Marvel's already only on like 17%. Thanos' blessings just expired, however we do get that fury because Cal Obsidian's awakened, and that's gonna be pretty much all she wrote. 66 hits, 69, 70, 71 hits and we're done. So we went down from 110 to 71. Now, as we all know, this Juggernaut fight is like always one of the more annoying fights in Labyrinth, and that's pretty much the reason why people don't just casually clear entire Realm of Legends when they choose farm potions. It's just because that unstoppable mechanic is annoying to wait out, and that is also gonna reflect here in like fight time. I think not really in the number of hits, but definitely in the time we spend fighting this guy. It's gonna delay us by quite a bit. But yeah, and also this AI, I must add, like, it's so weird, like, because Cal Obsidian kind of also relies on AI acting the way you do, because you do want to get those parries in, you do want to throw those heavy attacks, and if the AI is kind of like dancing about, it can definitely mess you about. But yeah, anyway, so we got 35 hits, we got our level 3, we shot that one off, and now he's already on 36% only. And that's with us only at 42 hits in the fight. Obviously our damage output is kind of like die down now here as soon as our blessings expire, but he's still only at 21% and we're only 50 hits in. It's quite amazing, especially for a rank 1 6-star. And yeah, so the numbers he's putting out are quite incredible. But yeah, so here a level 2 and he's nearly dead. We just need landing a couple of last hits. That's it, 69 hits for this Juggernaut, so still slightly less than that Captain Marvel took, but the fight was actually longer. And now Rhino. At this point we are already on 8 persistent charges, so that means we're pretty much up there damage wise. We shoot off 3 heavy attacks, we activate our rout buff, and that's it. Now we're going to town with that Rhino. Luckily he's being aggressive, that means we can land more and more attacks in like at him while our route was still active, and that's why our damage just skyrocketed. Look at that, we're at 30 hits in, 31 hits in, and he was already like less than half health. That's quite insane. But yeah, so 12 armor breaks, so we're clearly dealing some solid damage over there. Now we can reactivate our route, shoot off the level 3, so 43 hits in, and let's go and see what's gonna happen to that Rhino. And that's all she wrote. So it took us 45 hits to take down this Rhino. And now we are at max missions completed and we're gonna go up against Storm. However, as we can see here, if you do not manage to land like Paris, ideally it's gonna be a bit trickier against Storm, because I think this fight actually took us a bit longer than the Rhino one did, just because the AI was like a bit more passive. She didn't want to get parried as quickly. That's why we couldn't like put so much damage on her initially. As we can see here, 24 hits, she's still at 60%. So this fight is not definitely going as well as the Rhino one, and that is one of the things with Skull Obsidian. If you want to put out max damage, you need to have your opponent really aggressive. Like, that is usually not a problem in endgame content, however it's still, when you get like a dodgy AI, it's not a great time, because you are kind of rushing yourself a bit to land in as many hits while your route is active or your Thunder's Blessings are active. Anyways, 43 hits and Storm goes down. So at this point we are already flying through Realm of Legends, but yeah, here you can see Vision is being like passive. He didn't want to get parried, he didn't want to throw his special attack, and we only landed like a couple hits on him, and our Thunder's Blessings are already kind of like over. So I decided to kind of like go a different route. Instead of activating route early on now, we're gonna be saving that up till the point like we get to the level 3, and meanwhile we're just gonna be trying to keep as many armor breaks on Vision as we possibly can. And let's see what happens when we do kind of change our tactic up a bit. We do not go for early route buff, and we just kind of wait it out till we get to the level 3. So now we activate level 3 at 33 hits in. He is at like 56% power, health, but, and that's all she wrote over there as well. Those are some insane level 3s. So next opponent is Black Panther. We are already in maxed out charges, so it shouldn't be a problem. You can see already the damage is quite insane. 40k crit on heavy attack after only 6 armor breaks, that's quite crazy. So the numbers Carl puts up definitely are kind of like undeniable and undisputable. However, before more and more people ask me what exactly I think about Call of Obsidian, we made a small slip up there. But yeah, before I answer that, I'm still not too sold on a character. The numbers he put out are great. I still definitely need to do some more testing, how viable it is, what kind of numbers he can put up in not so ideal matchups. So far, I'm liking him. He's good. He has done well in dungeons. He has done well in quite a bit of testing kind of quest, but I'm just not exactly sure where he is gonna fit in the game, because he doesn't have all that much of utility, and in all of the contest there aren't really many places you can properly open him up and kind of like get the most out of him, I think. So next we are up against Scarlet Witch. We're gonna have class disadvantage here. She didn't want to cooperate with us as well, and obviously she's gonna be stealing our power and crits and stuff like that. So this fight is gonna be a bit longer, a bit more annoying. It kind of like depends on what kind of RNG you get against Scarlet Witch. But yeah, back to Call Obsidian. I like him. I really do like him. Do I think he is a top 5 character? Definitely not. He doesn't offer much aside from damage, and we have plenty of characters that might not deal as much damage, but can definitely do a lot more in game, plus have really, really good damage. So do I think he's ever gonna be a top 5 character? Probably not. Unless there is like a new Labyrinth of Legends where he can fully open himself up. But again, with that, there's going to be the typical problem of ramp up. It's going to be a bit of a struggle to kind of get through initial fight. And I still think in kind of like new version of Labyrinth of Legends, obviously it depends what Kabam is going to put there, but Aegon is probably going to take the crown there anyways. I think he's great though. I do think he's kind of like top 20 character, maybe bottom of top 10. The fact that, yeah, that block proficiency still really bugs me. And damage is awesome, but there's no block proficiency, there are no immunities, there's hardly any utility apart from like being able to bypass away an auto block. And another bit of utility obviously is all the armor breaks with the Despair Mastery. As we can see here, we're mincing through that Wolverine, 35 hits in. We didn't even launch special 3, so we're gonna finish it off with like 40 hits. Realm of Legends Wolverine goes down. That's crazy. It's definitely crazy. But it's, I don't know, I just don't think that big damage is enough to make me feel in love with the character. Like, you know, when you get a new character that's absolutely amazing, has a great amount of utility, has a really fluid playstyle, you just immediately fall in love. I do like Kull, I do enjoy playing him, but just don't see him as like the top of the game, kind of just because of the damage. That being said, now that he's duped, I do like him a lot better, because that makes a ramp up a lot easier. So that's like a huge part of that problem that's kind of pretty much going away, just because he pretty much doubles the damage output in the early fights where you can't, where you don't have many persistent charges, because that route is giving him like a lot of extra damage plus that fury. So yeah, he is a lot better. He really does need that dupe to kind of shine. And he has been doing like great. And yeah, so here's the last fight. I didn't speed up this fight, so here again, just because we're gonna have like a good, really solid moment where he gets in some insane burst damage. So we did land our three heavy attacks. Now we're activating our route buff, and now we're starting to punish Hulk. Well, we still have 10 Thanos' Blessings out. Did we see? There was like a crit for 18k with 20k route damage. That's insane, and that's so early in fight. And if these fights would be like half, like 200k in 20 hits, that was crazy amount of damage. But again, I do wish people would kind of like think that damage isn't everything in game. Having a good base amount of damage is important. Having an awesome damage helps a character shine. Having like insane damage definitely helps a character to be noticed. But is it enough to kind of like maintain him in the metagame with all the crazy nodes Kabam is putting out? I don't think damage in itself is the only thing that character needs, and unfortunately Call Obsidian doesn't have too much more to offer. However, here is like a small spreadsheet I made, and here we can see the hit numbers and the time it took us to take down each opponent. So basically the quickest fight was Wolverine at 1 minute, and then the second quickest was Hulk at 104, I believe. On average, it took us about 1 minute 20 seconds, something like that, and basically like 40 something hits for like your medium fight. So that is insane. That's crazy. That's definitely really, really good for 6-star rank 1. However, once again, make your own conclusions. I'm still undecided where I would place this character. But as of now, he hasn't really proven himself in any piece of content as like a staple kind of character that everybody wants to play. So I'm not quick to jump on that hype train over there. But anyways, thank you very much for watching, guys, and I'm gonna catch you guys later. See ya.